Hi, my name's Denise McCabe and I'm a Stamping Up demonstrator in Australia on the New South Wales Central Coast, and this is my Make It Monday for today. Today we're going to make a bay window card. I saw this on a US demonstrator site, Susan Campfield, and I thought I'll have a go at that. So I have changed it around to be sort of more in line with the Australian sizing, and you can get two out of one piece of A4 cardstock. So I've used the Daffodil Afternoon DSP that's free with a $90 order during celebration, and so this is the way it looks, like a bay window, and it can lie flat to post and it fits in a normal sized envelope. So we're going to have a go at doing it with the New Horizons DSP, because this card really tends to lend itself to designer series paper rather than stamping, I feel. So that's what we're going to do. So I shall put my phone up into the holder and we can get started. So I'll just make sure that's in view. Yes. So as you can see, it's got the standard bay window shape. And it lies flat and goes in a normal sized envelope. So it's really cool. I always like a good foldy, fancy fold card, and I like them when they're not too difficult, because sometimes they can be just so tricky and difficult to make that it takes the joy out of making them. Before we start that, I'll just show you my online card class, and that's running until the end of celebration, which is now the 16th of March. So if you place a $50 order or more with me between now and the 16th of March, you will get this online card class sent out to you. So you get everything cut up and scored and die cut out. The only thing you won't get is the stamped images. You have to do your stamp sentiments yourself. So this is using the Daffodil Afternoon DSP from Celebration and the Daffodil Daydreams bundle, the dies. So the first card's really, really easy, and it's just a piece of the beautiful designer series paper, some of the gold shimmer ribbon, a sentiment, and the butterflies. I know what I've forgotten to put in the ones I've just cut up today is an insert. I must do that. This one's using the dies and some mother of pearl paper run through the stripes and splatters embossing folder. And this one is a gatefold card and my instructions. So it's just a simple gatefold card using the beautiful ornate layers frames. And this is the contour, scalloped contour dies, and once again the daffodil dies. So all you've got to do is stamp your own sentiment. So with any $50 order or more online using this host code till the end of February, and when March clocks over, I'll put a new host code up, you will get this card class mailed out to you and a link to a video tutorial. So I just wanted to show that to you. So let's get started. So I've stamped inside and I put a bit of Winker Stella on the daffodils. So that's just gave it a little bit of a pop. So I do have my dimensions here that I converted from American dimensions, and they're not that different. So your cardstock is just cut in half, so I do put my arm out as well. So I've just made it a fraction shorter. I think America's dimensions had it nearly at 11 centimeters, but to get two out of one piece of cardstock, I've just made it a fraction, just 10.5 centimeters, the way we normally do a card this way. And then this is 27.8. centimeters, 0.8, yes, 0.8. So you just cut that little strip off. And then you're going to score it at 1 centimetre. (4.8 centimeters), 9.2 centimeters, 13 centimeters, and 13.9. That's 1, 2, 3 bays. I just got to think about this. Oh yeah, and 13.9. Yes, that's right. That's right. Okay, so that's your scoring. Now I will just put my trimmer to one side and I will show you how it folds. So this is folded in half. And then this first little one is a valley fold. Then the next one is a mountain fold. They're the names that they're called. Then the next one's a valley. No, that's a mountain as well. I apologize. It's a mountain. And then the next little one is a valley. So that's what you end up with. Okay. So that's your card base. So we'll put that there. Now we'll bring a piece of paper in. So you need 10.2 centimeters by 6 inches, or 15.2. So because this is got a lot of water, that's what I think this looks like. We're going to do it this way. So 10.212, still keep some water there. We can use that for something else. And then we're going to cut 0.5 centimeter. That's very tiny, I know, but you can see. We could go 0.8. We could make it a little bit bigger if you like. Well, let's do that. Is that going to stuff us up though? No, I don't believe it is. So we'll go 0.8 and just keep them in line so you can put your puzzle pieces back together. The next one you cut at 3.5. Let me change my instructions here. The next one's 3.5 centimetres. Oops, that's moved. There we go. And the next one is 4 centimetres. And the next one is 3.5 centimetres. And then we'll do another 0.8. And then we'll keep that one for the closure. Okay, so let me just move in and I'll bring my, I'll get my little glue mat and I'll get my glue. The first thing you're going to do is, so with the bookbinding cards we've done before, that's what we're going to do. We're going to close it down like this. So let me just put a little bit of glue down here. And you can use tear and tape, but you need something that's going to stay stuck down. So glue or the tear and tape is the best option here. I've got a little bit of glue on the outside, so I'll just get rid of that now. Okay, so that's that. Now I'm going to put my piece there. So this piece is going to go here. This piece will go here. This piece will go here. Here. So it's just putting your scene back together again. So I'm using my glue, because I like to be able to get it and wiggle it around if I need to. So there's not going to be much border because we've gone a little bit wider. Move up a bit. There we go. Move over a bit. That's why I like the glue, because I can just sort of move it into position. Then we're going to do this with glue. Next piece. I do love this paper. I'm going to try and start playing with other products. But I've just been having a run of this New Horizon stuff, and I still haven't done everything I want to do with it. But I've got some new other products that I've got to have a play with. Oops. Can't pick it up. There it is. So that's our front piece. I'm just going to... I've got my tissue here somewhere that I've used earlier today on cards. Okay. And oopsie. So I had a card class on Saturday with some lovely ladies, and we did the alcohol ink wash technique, and that was really fun. So I'm holding card classes now in person, and I'm doing like 4 cards at one class, kind of like a stamper stack, but it's only 4 cards. And the other Saturday class is a technique class. So this one's going on this little end. Now I just want to make sure I'll get that piece out of the way. I just want to make sure that's lined up right. There we go. And I'll put my glue away. So that's how it's going to look. And what we do with this piece is we get dimensionals. This lot should do. And we put, it's a bit close to the edge. We just put fingers and thumbs today. And then we're going to butt some up, just like not quite on the edge, and that will become the reason for that will become apparent in a minute. I'm going to just put that there, and I'm going to get my other big pieces. I'll chop up edges for another time. Okay. I might move this one to here. So yeah, I do two Saturdays a month. One is 4 cards using a bundle of products, and the other class is a technique class. And I am doing one Wednesday a month, simple stamping using Stamping Up card kits. So that's more in design for the beginner. And I might start another Wednesday class for scrapbooking. I'll just see how I go. So this is going to go here. I hope you can see what I'm doing. Just placing that up on dimensionals. Now I haven't got that very straight, so I want to pull that off and try and get it a bit straighter. That's okay, they've stayed where they need to go. Oh, my little card's just misbehaving now. Okay, so we're going to pop that there, like so. Now, because we've left a bit of a gap there, it looks like I didn't glue very well on my card down here. So let me just fix that for a minute. I'm going to hold that down. So I'll just hold that down. So yeah, I was asked yesterday if I do scrapbooking classes, and I have offered them in the past, but I haven't had a lot of interest. So I thought I might start doing some scrapbooking classes. Okay, so that's going to just tuck in under there, like so. And that's your bay window card. Pretty simple. They look, these fancy fold cards are a little bit tricky because they look so tricky. But you can see that that wasn't that tricky at all. Oh, look, I know what I did wrong. Oh, no, I didn't. I thought I'd put the piece down. So you just put your dimensionals in a fraction so that this can tuck in. I don't think I've got that one in. I think I put them the wrong way around on my piece of paper. But it's working, so that's the main thing. Okay. And see, then it lies flat to post, to put in an envelope. So what we're going to do now is get the sailing boat. Now, I think the big boat might be too big because this is, maybe not. Just trying. I thought it might be too big, but I don't think it's going to be. Honestly, everything's sticking to me. Or we could use the smaller boat. Maybe the smaller boat. Yes, I think the big boat might be a bit too much. And I'll get a block out. And we might get Knight of Navy and a little bit of Mr. White cardstock. So I'll just put it there, like so. Get a blender pen and we're just gonna move the ink into the hull of the sailing boat. Don't do too much because it'll start scuffing the paper up. We could do the sails as well, just a little bit. There we go, just a little bit, just to move that ink around a little bit. I'll keep my Knight of Navy out. Now I shall get my mini cut emboss machine because we only need a little machine for this little boat. So don't forget, if you place a $50 order with me through to the end of February, you'll go in the draw to win a brand new mini cut emboss machine. I've got quite a few people in that draw, so if you want to be in it to win it, isn't that the same? Make sure you place your $50 order before the 28th of February. I'm going to draw it on the 1st of March because I will not be at work that day. So I've got a random spinning wheel thing on my iPad that I've loaded and I've put the names into that, so it'll spin and it'll be a random draw. Okay, let's have a look. Get rid of my plates. Pull that off. There's my little boat. So that was the sailing home stamp set that's in the annual catalogue, and I just think I shall put him there, or will I put him further up higher? I've got to work out where I'm going to put my greeting. That's, or might not need a greeting. That's the other thing we've got to think about. I will stick that on with a dimensional. And a mini dimensional at the top. These Makeup Mondays come around very quickly. There. Now the other thing I could do is I could stamp some birds. There's birds in both the Horizon stamp set and in the Sailing Home stamp set. Now I'm going to use the Sailing Home ones because there's only three and I don't want to get carried away and make a mess with my birds. So I shall use my Sailing Home stamp set for the birds. Look at that. It's okay. We'll figure something out. Damn it. Oh, I need that for a greeting. Let's think. Relax and enjoy your day. Is that what it says? Relax and enjoy it. That would fit on a piece of cardstock and my oval punch, I feel. Let me. Oval punch, where are you? There you are. And so this is the double oval punch. It's $31 and it's really good. You can just use the scallop oval or you can use the plain oval and layer it on top of the scallop oval. So I'm going to use just the scallop oval because that fits my greeting best. This won't fit into that one. So that's what I'm doing. There we go. And up. Goodness me. I'll just get my dauber and I'll just fluff around the edges here. So, as I've said, this New Horizons DSP just makes the most wonderful mail cards. It just makes the most wonderful cards, really. yeah, it's really, really nice. So I can do that and I'll have to think of some bling or something I can put over that. So before I do anything else, let's clean off my stamps and get them away before I put my card into it. If anybody doesn't have the chamois, it's so beautiful. It's a great tool. It is more this color when you get it. The ink does stain it, but you just rinse it under the tap and wash it out to clean it. And it's really handy to have. For years, I just used baby wipes. Then I used the Stampin' Scrub, but I do prefer the chamois the best. It's $14. It doesn't come in that case. I've bought extra cases to put it in, but you could put it in a Tupperware or a Sistema container. You don't have to buy a stamp case, but we do sell these stamp cases empty if you wanted to. Okay, so let me think. Shall I put, I think I'll put the greeting up on dimensionals as well. So we'll put them more in the middle because it's going on the middle of the bay window. There we go. Now we've got to come up with an idea to cover up my shadow that happened. this is my bling tin. I've got all my bling in here. So let me think. I don't want anything pretty because that won't be... Oh, we could do blue. That's not... Although, is that a bit sparkly for a male? I think it is. Why do males have to be so difficult? They're not really. I shouldn't say that. Okay, brushed metallic adhesive dots. I like these ones. So we're going to get a big one to cover up the boo-boo. Is it going to cover it up, though? Not quite. I know what we're going to do. I think. No, there. What else is big enough? See, I've done a big boo-boo and I've got to try and cover it up. Pastel pearls, that's not going to work. Opal rounds, that's not going to work. Matte black dots. Ooh, is that going to be big enough? I'm not sure. Not really. Damn it. This is what happens when you're not careful when you're stamping. I don't think the gilded gems would work, but they would cover it. So maybe for today, we're going to have to go gilded gems. We'll use a large one up here. Okay. Now, I'm only doing that big gem because of my bad stamping. And we'll put that there. So, otherwise I might have used the metallic ones. Now, I don't have... Because I did it on the vanilla, I didn't have to have an insert in here. So, I will cut an insert. So, let me just see what size I need to cut, and it will be in white, so that's 10 centimeters, so I need 9.5 by 10. Oops, so bear with me while I get some white cardstock to cut that. Okay. Nine point five by ten. There we go. So relax and enjoy your day. I don't think I want to put anything else inside until I decide. Well, it's a birthday card, I'm pretty sure, but a bit of snail and turn it around the right way, Denise. And you just get a little border all the way around. There we go. And that is a bay window card. Just tucks in and stands like that, or that's what it looks like. How cool is that? I think that's really cool with the scenery DSP, but also, like, this is really nice with the daffodil DSP. I was thinking I might give this one to my mum for Mother's Day because she had a bay window in her bedroom in their last, their house in Carrion. So, and she loved her bay window, so I thought I might give that one to Mum. So there you go, that's a bay window card, and I've used the New Horizons DSP, which is just beautiful. There's so many things you can do with it. And I've used the Sailing Home boat and birds, don't overstamp it, and the Relax and Enjoy Your Day greeting from the Horizon bundle. So I hope you guys have enjoyed that. I really like foldy cards that aren't too difficult. And this one isn't too difficult, really. And I love the way it can go flat and fit into an envelope. I really like that option. So thanks for watching me this week. And I'll be back on... Actually, no, I won't be back on Friday this week with Card and a Cuppa because I'm going out to lunch with some friends that we make cards together. So I might do my Card and a Cuppa next Saturday. So I'll put that up on my Facebook page and let you know. But thanks for watching today, and I hope you have a lovely week. Bye-bye.